Hi, I'm the Jordan, coach of the Virginia Vike Vaults, and welcome to week two of the High Roller VGC Draft League. I am against KJ Chicken and his amazing team. The more I've looked at this team, the more impressed I've been by it. It has an incredible diversity of offensive tools, defensive tools, disruptive tools, and overall synergy. I mean, there's just so many different ways this team can come together. I can't account for them all, but I can get inside my opponent's head and think about the things he's most likely to lean on. This Alolan Marowak Okos my entire six. No exceptions, even my likely Dynamax targets. So a real threat to deal with, especially under Trick Room. The Celesteela is the best Pokemon in our entire format. Beats all of the things that supposedly counter it, depending on the circumstance, an incredible Pokemon. And I'm going to have to beat this Trick Room mode here with Aromatisse and Gastrodon and Registeel. And then the Thwacky is a real problem. Fake Out, Grassy Glide, Terrain Control, just a lot. But you'll see my tools. Let's get into this dense analytical strategy section. I made a team that I thought I was pretty happy with, and then I mocked with Jace. Thank you, Jace. But I got beat hard. Even when I was making good plays, reading the right switch-ins and whatnot, I was getting stalled out by Registeel and just overwhelmed by Marowak. And so I had to go back to the drawing board and think, what's got the most solid matchup into the most mons? It might not be winning, it might not be the strongest mon I have, but Slowking, unlikely hero here, with the amazing coverage of fire, water, and grass, beats every single mon here that I think is likely to come. By the way, green is very likely to come, in my opinion. Light blue is potentially coming, and dark blue, probably not. I mean, all the mons have options, so it's possible, but I'm looking at these main eight for prep, and Slowking hits seven of them super effectively, the only exception being the Aromatisse. And so, with the max special attack in the life orb and getting that Oko usually on the Dynamax Marowak, which is pretty exciting, I have to be very careful if there's a Gastrodon threatening to redirect the water move, but I do Oko the Gastrodon as well with Overgrowth. I Flare to Oko the Thwacky. I can get Okos on a lot of different mons here, and I do survive a Thwacky Grassy Glide, which is pretty helpful. I do survive a Fake Out plus Grassy Glide over two turns, so that's kind of helpful. So I have mostly decent matchups here. So it's okay into the Celesteela. Nothing really beats Celesteela, but if it doesn't bring a grass move, then I'll be beating the Celesteela. And then if I can set up the sun with max flare, then I might have the oomph to break through this Registeel. It's gonna need some help though, it kinda depends. So frequently, my game plan is to set Trick Room with Slowking, using Tangrowth as a redirection support. Heatran is the other main offensive Dynamax threat, because it has that fire and grass, which is so useful for beating this team, and also Earth Power is very good here. I cannot live ground moves from Lando, even Dynamax. I can't live a ground move, I can't live a Steela ground move, I can't live a Marowak ground move, I can't live a Inteleon ground move, Gastrodon. So it's just, I can't beat the ground moves and this week, so I'm just gonna run the Air Balloon and just try to disrupt them. I find that people see the Air Balloon that reveals itself, which is not great, but they usually target that mon to try to break the Air Balloon, and I should get a lot of mileage out of protecting Heatran. Or at least take two hits to go down, I can survive the water moves coming from Inteleon or Gastrodon. This is a pretty good matchup into Celesteela. Heatran is an amazing Pokemon with amazing stats, and I don't want to lean on it too hard. I have had a lot of success with Heatran in the past, mainly because you don't bring it every week, and so I won't, but this week it's really, really great, so it's coming back. Can't beat the Registeel by itself. Maybe with Sun, it's an Oko, but I need multiple fire moves and Sun set up by either one of these two. Mamoswine. Mamoswine is bad in this circumstance. Cannot live a lot of moves from the Steels or from Marowak, but in Trick Room, with the Iron Ball, I'm slower than Registeel, Celesteela, Marowak, even the Gastrodon. I'm very slow, so I might be able to get that surprise factor going for me. It does good damage with Ice and Ground into most things. It's even a guaranteed Oko on Lando with just the Mineral Icicle Spear, so I can go with the safest ice move here. And I do live a Wacky Grassy Glide, so Mamoswine can do some things here. If they're leaning into Trick Room as their strategy, then I hide Mamoswine in the back. If I need Trick Room, then Mamoswine might be a supportive option while Slowking Dynamaxes. We shall see. I can Earthquake next to Air Balloon Heatran, or Drifblim, or Thundurus, or Tangrowth for that matter. My team's pretty good at tanking Earthquakes. Tangrowth. Tangrowth is a thorn in my opponent's side. All four of its moves are potentially a big issue for my opponent. So, fun fact, in my 8 Draft League seasons, I have never brought or clicked an RNG sleep move. So the only sleep move I've ever brought is Yawn, and I just don't like them. I find them distasteful, makes the game very random as heavy, but trust me when I say that I've exhausted my other options of beating this Trick Room setter here. You'll see what I tried to beat this Trick Room setter, but putting it to sleep is, I think, my safest option. Knocking off Marowak's Thick Club stops it from being the terror that it is with a Thick Club. These Stallmons don't want their leftovers knocked off. Wacky doesn't want its Eviolite knocked off. So that's a very good move. And then Bullet Seed. Bullet Seed beats Inteleon and Gastrodon pretty handily, even if they bring a Grass Resist Berry. And then the main thing that Tangrowth is likely to do is to just redirect a turn of attacks so Slowking can set Trick Room. I would be fine if Tangrowth goes down turn one so that I can get Trick Room, because then I can bring in the Iron Ball Mamo. But every turn Tangrowth remains alive, it is a problem for my opponent. Finally, the blimp. This is not how I would normally use the blimp as an endgame like defense mon, but I can beat the Registeel with it. I struggled so much thinking about ways to reliably beat such a bulky Stallmon as Registeel. And the best way to do it is to haze off its defense boost and then start setting up my own, because I have access to recovery and strength sap. It's always doing healing up half because Registeel Clear Body does not reduce its attack. So Calm Mind Shadow Ball with strength saps should beat this Registeel. It doesn't do a lot until it gets boosts and I can haze them away. I can heal and Registeel can't heal besides leftovers. There is a bridge too far for Drifblim. I can't bring it against the Celesteel, particularly if it has a rock move. And then Marowak. I put max defense on this thing and a ghost resist berry. So Marowak KOs my Drifblim 2 times over. I can only live 93% of the time. And that's just what I'm going to have to take, the 93%. The good news is that once my berry is removed from me, Marowak usually runs Poltergeist as its ghost move. And so if I can live the last hit of the Dynamax, then it won't be able to Poltergeist me anymore because my item is gone. So its other moves do significantly less. And if I strength zapped that turn, then I'm actually walling a Marowak, potentially. So it has a couple of winning matchups, and it's my main defensive piece here. Haze to stop their snowballing effects. Yeah, so we'll see. I mean, I've got this as my ace in the hole for a Registeel and for a couple of other situations. Thundurus is another kind of plan B. It's coming. Game 2 or 3, if I see that their main threats are special, Eerie Impulse can really shut that down. And it's my fast mode. Thundurus with Heatran and Scary Facing can allow me to be going first. Dark Pulse beats Marowak and Discharge beats a number of things, but I really have to know what they're bringing before I can safely bring the Thundurus this week. Yeah, like if Marowak has Lightning Rod and it's redirecting Eerie Impulse away from the special threat, then that's no bueno. So finally, I told you, I had iterations of this team, and this new iteration with Dynamax Slowking, I haven't tested it, but what was going before was not working. I tried to circle throw, tried to be cute by throwing out the Trick Room setter before it could set Trick Room. I tried to neutralizing gas taunt to stop the Trick Room. I tried to fake out an Icy Wind to win in fast mode, and I found that defense just didn't get things done because they had the typing matchups against me in a lot of situations. They had a bit better ability to snowball with their mons than I did. I missed out on some Okos. No matter how I EV this. So defense is not the move this week. I wanted to play defensively, but that's going to have to be next week. So offense, well-placed offense, max flaring with Heatran or Slowking. I need to overwhelm my opponent. And I mean, this is a tough matchup for me. I'm going to give myself maybe 30% chance, but I'm not going to count myself out. I will never count myself out. Wish me luck. Okay, Registeel, Aromatisse, no Thwacky. Good news. Registeel. Okay, so I see so much Trick Room here. Unfortunately, a Meowstic. We're gonna have to deal with Prankster due to us not bringing Psychic Terrain. Steela. Meowstic. So Gastrodon's good. Tangrowth, Slowking with Heatran and Mamo is likely our move. Steel, or do I assume my dual flares can handle it? I don't know, but Iron Ball Mamo is gonna be relevant here. Even if they leave the Trick Room, I might just put their setter to sleep and set my own Trick Room. I don't want to have to, you know, double reverse. We'll see. Good luck, have fun, KJ. Celesteela Aromatisse. So, I outspeed Aromatisse in all likelihood. So, Celesteela can try to get going with Steel Spikes or whatever, hit me down to Sash, but... So, Steela shouldn't Oko Slowking. I think I have that calc. Yeah. I survive a Slowking hit, so I think I can afford to not redirect. Put Steela to sleep would be great. And... just go for it. Okay. Max is Celesteela. Hit him with that shit, Dutch. Is this like a helping hand? Or... yeah, here's the thing. Unless they speed invest their Aromatisse, which is highly unusual, then they should just go to sleep here. Okay. Helping Hand Quake into Slowking. It's like, okay. Please hit the Sleep Powder. Safety Goggles. Okay. So we're currently stalling out a Celesteela Max. Slowking took a little bit too much damage, so I'm not interested in... there's no time for me to have good commentary here. But... I know it's not weakness policy, so I can just throw a flamethrower at it. Unfortunately, it's a Spitak drop. Oh, it doesn't matter, actually. Well, that's something. It is something. Safety Goggle Celesteela. Okay. So, two Quake boosts means Heatran's in a really tough spot here. Oh, I can't get anything going here. And attack, it's physical Steela. So when they reveal the air balloon, they might double, go Moonblast into Quake. I don't really have much besides putting things to sleep right now. Can I really max this Mamo against the Celesteela? It sounds super dubious. Okay. We've noticed rock and ground. So that's another bad thing. Celestia has Earthquake and Stomping Tantrum. Against the other stuff. Marowak. So yeah, so I've lost this game. How did it get so bad so quickly? Maxi Mamo seems like a death sentence. Is this a double protect? Info. More info. Last turn of Trick Room, please. I don't know how to find it in time. I need to protect again. I think it's the last turn of Trick Room. I think they know that I had to max Heatran or just go for double protect. Rock and ground, and it's got to have at least one stab move. Steel, probably. Come on, where do I find if there's Trick Room? Is it done? I don't know where to find it. One more turn to Trick Room. Okay, well, this is my best turn. I just have to assume, I mean, it's a very strong neutral hailstorm. I eat a lot of damage with Moonblast. I definitely lose this game. How could I not stop this somehow? So I could have gone for the immediate max Slowking. Protect. Okay. Good move. Iron Head or whatever does lots of damage. Hopefully they go for Heavy Slam and they just can't. That'd be dope. What a disaster. And I've revealed Iron Ball Mamo. What a disaster. GG. So that's the Celesteela. So a physical Celesteela indicates that I cannot bring the Eerie Impulse Thundee into play. So Gogglesteela is the only real answer to Tangrowth here. Heatran Slowking. My ability to set Trick Room if necessary. Like, they've got no speed on their whole squad. I'm gonna guess Steela is Protect, Steel, Rock, Ground. It's quite good coverage overall. So I think I put Blim in the back and Mamo. they're gonna try to double into the Heatran, like... I'm not sure how they're gonna play this. Obviously, they have no reason they need to switch things up. I have no proof that I can beat Celesteela Aromatisse. I just can't let Steela get going. It might go for a Quake into Slowking to get its special defense going, but let's just do it. It has not shown a Protect yet, so I go before Steela, which is not a surprise. I think I'm faster than Max Speed Steela, so yeah. They're likely gonna max again. The Helping Hand, or they go for just the Quake as they Moonblast to break the air balloon. But now it's a shootout, and speed is kind of flexible here. I have immediate speed advantage with Heatran. Okay, Flamethrower and Sun, please pick this up. I beg of you. They might set Trick Room here. Yeah, Rock Fall into Heatran, okay. Alright. And then they set Trick Room. But I should deal with the Steela here. If Slowking, Life Orb Slowking has it in him. Okay. Now they set Trick Room for question mark. Marowak? I mean, if they set Trick Room, Slowking still outflanks Marowak. Trick Room, okay. Now they do have the After You option. This might be a guard. Like, Marowak ground move is a lot. Oh wait, it wasn't even in Sun, but Steela changed the weather to Sandstorm. Big guard read, I think, I mean, it's not really a read, but just do they read the read type stuff. But I can't let Heatran get hit here. I have to have them throw the ground move and hit them with a Scald. Come on, Slowking. I just didn't know the calc. This might outco. Nice, Slowking. Shouldn't have guarded, unfortunately, but there are worse things that could have happened. Registeel in last. So what have we seen on Aromatisse? We've seen Helping Hand and Trick Room. Yeah, there's the Registeel. So I think it kind of protects here. Did I put Driplim in the back? Please tell me I put Driplim in the back. I did. Okay, so I think I'm in good shape here. I'm gonna set the Sun. And then... I mean, this doesn't hurt, right? I kind of see a Protect coming. Well, I guess no Protect, but I feel like they probably should have protected Registeel facing down a Flare. This should do some good damage. And I'm getting Sun. And Amnesia, okay. I have Haze, Driftblim, and soon they will not have a Trick Room setter. Sun is good. So this is just turn three. There's two more turns of Trick Room. Leftovers, Amnesia, Registeel. So thank the Lord I brought this Driftblim. So, body press into Heatran. I don't have time to calc. Damn it. Body press into Heatran, I don't think it does quite enough. And I'm honestly... It's okay if Registeel goes after the Heatran. But... So I need to get this Steela... So the Aromatisse has Heal Pulse, and so I need to be targeting the Aromatisse. Heal Pulse is just too much. Yeah. Insun, Slowking with 3 KOs. All right, so let's see that body press. Oh, just Amnesia. Just thinks, just hopes that I'm all special attackers, which I am, but I do have a haze. So there. Yeah, so this will be bad. He's gonna get the +6, but Trick Room will be over. I'll haze it away. This will be fine. This is a 4v1 now. How do they adjust? All right, so one more turn of Trick Room, right? Info. One more turn of Trick Room. Like, I don't care if they get me. Well, no, so Slowking walls a lot more effectively than... Wait. Actually, swapping into Drifblim is actually kind of decent here. With just another Frith flamethrower. Eventually, with enough time, I'll get a flamethrower burn. Or a crit. I mean, that's always possible. All right, so I haze. I wonder if I even need to haze. But I'll haze. And I'll flamethrower. Because if they have only body press, they probably have body press and iron head. Okay, they protect, amnesia, body press. I would expect iron defense, meaning they've lost this game, and I wonder they're just waiting around for information. I'm gonna have to reveal the set to break this Registeel, but anyway. Shouldn't do much. Did a little bit, and that's all I had left. No more sun is a shame. So I can combine flamethrower. It's fine. I would think they need iron defense to make body press worthwhile. Or they just are max fizz def, iron head, and body press. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's tough to fit everything. All the terrible toxic stall stuff that you want to fit on this Registeel at once. So it's at 0. I forget exactly how much I'm doing, but a lot, at least half. So then they amnesia here. Body press the Heatran. Okay, did about 100. Thank you. And they can protect one more turn, but yeah, they're just playing out for the information. So they're gonna leave the Stila. Or I mean, they might put it back, but they're not gonna do the same lead. GG. Thing is, I've shown more than they have. And I think their Marowak is their best adjustment. It's very, very strong against Slowking and Heatran. I think Heatran in the lead is the move still. I haven't revealed a grass move on either Heatran or Slowking. I'd love it if they switched into Gastrodon. But just immediate max Heatran is my best bet here because they can't immediately ground move me. Unless they go for like Stila Marowak. I still haven't seen the fourth move on Registeel. TR, heal, help. A minute. I don't see why I change, besides I want to change. Because they can do their best lead against Heatran, but I hit Heatran. I hit everything super effectively. Ground onto Marowak, fire onto Stila, grass onto Gastrodon. I might just protect the Heatran turn one. Yeah, this is the move. I guess I didn't show Mamo's last. Good luck, have fun again. So they know more about my sets than I do theirs. I need to target down this Aromatis because it's Heal Pulse. Yeah, I'm unsure about this. I've only seen Rock and Ground on Stila, as far as I know. And so, what stops me from throwing out flares into this guy? Because I can Grass Knot the Gastrodon. What if I, like, protect and Dynamax the Slowking? It's in such a good spot. My only concern is about doing the same thing and getting red, right? They can protect with Stila. They haven't the whole time, but why should I change? I mean, I'm gonna lose this game one, but they need to... Okay, they switch out into Marowak, right? As I said, Trick Room? Gastro, okay. I mean, this is a lot of damage for a Gastro to take. This was pretty smart, and this is when they set Trick Room. It's just if they, so I can't Grass Knot this Dynamax Gastrodon if that's what they're going for. Wish I had protected and not committed to maxing. So this is a Moonblast. They Moonblast to break the air balloon, and then they ground with Gastrodon. They're not gonna use Max Geyser. The problem is here, I need to guess that the Gastrodon is not maxing. That's all I have, because one ground move and I'm toast. So I can switch into Drifblim. I can waste my entire Dynamax. I I just have to go for the bet here. Unfortunately, Grass Knot might not work if they Dynamax. Okay, they didn't Dynamax. This should be a lot. It's not a one-hit KO because Grass Knot's not full power against Gastrodon because, oh, well, Rindo, okay. So they Heal Pulse here. Meaning they do not get to, what are they, they're gonna Yawn, Slowking. So this is when they Protect. So I get to Max Grass and Quake while I'm at it, the Aromatisse. Yeah, they can Protect if they really want to. Do I switch out to avoid this? No, I need the pressure on the Gastrodon. They can Protect, fine. But, okay, so they're gonna get to use a water move? Cause I'm still air ballooned though. Unless they've forgotten about air balloon. Cover. All right. Expert stalling of the Dynamax. But I'm doing a lot of damage to them, aren't I? Expert stalling the Dynamax is not looking great. This is a protect and try to wake up. It's kind of free. They're gonna target the Heatran, Boom Blast, ground move. I mean, just anything else is just not terribly productive for them. They can Boom Blast the Slowking. That would be fine, it'd be something. Marowak, okay, so we see the four. They're gonna try to preserve their Trick Room Setter. These yawns. Info. One more turn of Trick Room. Drop into Drifblim as Trick Room ends. Hope I don't have to eat a Poltergeist. I do live a Poltergeist with the gross Resist Berry. Dynamax Marowak, okay. Not quite enough. So then they Poltergeist the Slowking, okay. Shadow Bone. Okay, so I don't know how they knew that I was gonna bring it, because Gazeeb Berry. They maybe just don't trust Poltergeist. But Trick Room is not up. They do not have a setter. And I have Pokemon. Now the most they can do here is protect Marowak. Please tell me there's one more turn of Sun so I can get a Solar Beam. That'd be so dope. Where did all the Sun go? I can't Solar Beam anymore, and that's really bad for me. But I can Earth Power, and it should pick it up. Fortunately, no time to do calcs. I'm still air ballooned. So I live a Shadow Bone with the Ghost Berry. Air balloons, I think, messing up their plans a fair bit. Patient waiting out the Dynamax. They're waiting to Dynamax here. Ghost Berry, Unburden. I can't really stop aromatize in one turn, though. Oh, but I'm asleep. Oh, sleep. Okay, so that's probably game. Now we get a Protect Trick Room. Why wouldn't it be? That's my question. Yeah. But I'm still air ballooned. I could have seen it, but they haven't protected. They haven't really shown me that that's how they play yet, so now that I see it, I can adjust, but set's almost over, unfortunately. So a Max Phantasm destroys Drifblim and puts a defense drop on Heatran as they use Moonblast on Aromatisse to break the air balloon. But I don't really see how switching is any good for me. Oh wait, well, so I know that I don't have to deal with a Registeel because Gastrodon's here. So. Do I have to stall out all of Trick Room here? I need to try to at least have two Mons. Now, Iron Ball Wham Mamoswine will get his shot at the Marowak. Unless the fourth move is magically after you this whole time. There's the Marowak. It's interesting that I still don't know some things about their sets. Oh, that is pretty unfortunate. Yeah. When are they gonna break this air balloon? I don't understand. Unless they double up. So now they get to double up. Because I protected. If I could have seen this far enough ahead, maybe, but. Now they get to double up, and, do I need to go to knock out? So, I think I need a double protect. What else can I do? What else can I do? Now, I'll be kicking myself if there's something I'm missing here, but they got a Moonblast, right? They have to. They just have to double up into the Heatran. They just have to, and I miss it again. Why do they keep doing this? Why? It makes no sense. I could have KO'd them repeatedly. I am so lost. Wow. I guess they knew that, I lose to, Heal Pulse at this point. So. I need to see Trick Room stats too. So only if the Aromatisse dies. This was good for me. Please get 5 Icicle Spears. That's all I ask. 4 might be enough. Oh, okay, we got a bit of good luck. So we have 1 turn of Trick Room. And a chance to hit this Marowak. So I know that Marowak can beat me, and that it doesn't. It's not going to protect again in all likelihood. It's just whether I can randomly beat this Steela when it's got a turn of advantage against me. I feel like I need hella crits, but what are you going to do? This is my chance to get rid of the Marowak, so. And it's very deadly, so. We likely lose 1v1 versus Steela. Iron Head, right? Yeah. And it just one shots. Okay. GG, KJ. Well played. Good adjustment to Gastrodon. Heal Pulse was just a lot. It's really unfortunate to lose. Losing O2 is really, really a lot. Definitely not what I'm used to, but nothing's insurmountable. We'll try our hardest next week.